Namaskara. Today I am going to explain about a data flow modeling. In that one we are going to see an operators we are going to use for a data flow modeling. Along with that one we are going to see some examples on a data flow modeling. Okay, let us go on to the slides. Okay. Today's agenda is for explaining about an operators and then data flow modeling examples. Okay, in an operators we have an arithmetic operator, logical operator, relational operator, equality operator, bitwise operator, reduction operator, shift operator, concatenation operator, conditional operator. Okay, now let us see an first arithmetic operator. Okay, when you are speaking about an arithmetical operator, we have an multiply, divide, add, subtract and an modulus. I think everyone knows about what is multiply, divide and an add, subtract. Okay, here actually we can use a number of operator is in 2. The symbol we are going to use for a multiplication is in star. Okay, for example, if you want to multiply any two numbers A and B. Okay, in the last slides or in video screencast video, we have come across there we are using an basic gates and all those things. There actually we were using an only one bit operator. If you have specified anything with an input A comma B or anything like that, this one, it is an binary bits. Either it can store 0 or 1. Okay, you may come across multiply. Multiply means it need to be an any number. For example, if you have taken a 2 into 2 means approximately it need to get an output of an 4. Okay, 4 in the binary equivalent of 4 is an 100. Okay, in order to store those information, you need to have an at least 3 bit of your output variable. Okay, in order to declare those registers with an extension vector declaration, it has been shared with and documents. You need to go through that one, how you can declare and vectors and all those things, and how you can access to an only particular bits in an array has been given as a document for a self study. You need to go through that one. In the same way, you can use for and divide, there is a slash. For addition you have an plus, then for subtract you have an minus, then for modulus you can use an percentage. This is the basic of an arithmetic operators. Okay, now let us come for an logical operators. Here we have an three things. One is a logical negation, logical and a logical or. Okay, this is actually used for logical checking. Okay, this logical negation is, okay, for example, if you want to check then some certain condition, if it is not equal to 1 or not equal to 0, at that time we can go for an exclamatory that particular variable we have been declared. Okay, that is only single operand it has been using in order to check a single output. For example, if you want to check an output of any gates, after you got an output you can check that particular variable whether it is a not 0 or a not 1. For that condition you can use. Then you have a double ampersand. It is for checking a logical AND. Okay, here both the condition need to be satisfied. Okay, for example, if you are taking an A equal to 1 and an B equal to 1, if you are checking an A and B means it is going to truly check whether the both the operators having a same value, then only it is going to be given true answer, otherwise it is going to give a 0. Then there is a logical OR. In this logical OR, it is either one of the condition is satisfied out of those two operand, it will give a true result, otherwise it is going to discard to the next coming statement. This is all about logical operators. Okay, now let us go for a relational operator. I think everyone knows that how you can do a checking and greater than, less than or equal to, or greater than or equal to. I think probably you might be knowing these are the operators we are going to use. Okay, now let us go for equality operators. Okay, in this equality operator we are checking whether it is exactly equal, both the things. Okay, then for checking an inequality we are going to use a negation equality. Okay, before going for case equality, if we tell in any bit, usually we will tell that it has in two states, either 0 or 1. But practically speaking, there are another two states. There is an X unknown condition, then there is an Z high impedance turn off state. Okay, if it is any of the one input variables becomes to an X or a Z, the resultant will become to a purely Z. Okay, not to discard some don't case conditions, we will go on for case equality. In this case equality, it is going to check bitwise along with an X and an Z. If it is exactly matching with an X condition for an X condition, for example, the first bit, the last significant bit is an LSB is an X in an A input variable, if you have taken an example, then in an B, if it is also an X in the least significant bit, it is going to consider this as an case equally. It has been case equivalent, it has been equal. But if you have used these two operators, there it might have been result with an XXX. Okay, in the same way, you can go for a case inequality. Okay, now let us come for a bitwise operator. Okay, this bitwise operator is nothing but an going to do an bitwise. If you have an 8 bit vector of an A and an 8 bit vector of an B, all the particular position is going to do an bitwise operation, whether it is an AND or an XOR or an XNOR. These are the symbols we are going to use. The only one is a negation, this is a NOT operation. Whatever the input it has in there, it is going to complement. This ampersand is for an AND, this straight line is for an OR. Actually, it is present on the keyboard above your enter button. You need to use that one with a shift. Then you have a cap symbol for your XOR. Not to do an XNOR, you can just add an XNOR. Okay, here we have not listed a NAND or NOR anything like that. I think everyone knows in order to get a NAND, you can do a NOT operation of your AND operation. After doing an AND, you can just put an exclamatory symbol there. Okay, now let us go for a reduction operator. This, it is little bit different from your bitwise operator. Here actually what you are going to use, there we are having a two operators. Here it is going to for a single operator itself. For example, your A is an 8 bit length, 8 bit vector. What it is going to do, if you are given an ampersand negation, means it is going to do an AND operation between all the bit positions. Okay, from a 7th bit to 6th bit, it will do an AND operation. From 6th to 5th bit, it will do an AND operation. The resultant will be done with a 4th bit. The resultant will be done with a 3rd bit. The resultant will be done with a 2nd bit, 1st bit, and then 0. The final result, what it is going to get, it will be taken as a resultant of that particular bit. It is going to do among a single variable itself across all the vector length, what is the predefined length it is there. Okay, that is about your reduction operator. Then for shifting, and either you can do a right shift or a left shift. Okay, if it is double greater than symbol, it is going to do a right shift. If it is lesser than symbol, it is going to do a left shift. There you can specify the numbers here. Okay, what is the amount of bit positions you want to do? Okay, if you are just given a 1, it is going to do an only one shift. If you have specified 3, it is going to do a 3 bit shift. Okay, let us go for a next. Now let us see a conditional operator. In this conditional operator, we can see there is a question mark and a colon. Okay, actually the number of operators here used are 3. Before the question mark, we are going to check the condition. If that condition is true, it will jump to the variable what you have specified between question mark and a colon. If this condition is false, it will go to the after colon statement. Okay, we can see these things in an example. Okay, let us move on to the next concatenation operator. There in the concatenation is, for example, if you have gotten 2 results, okay, if you want to make them into and combine into a single variable, what you can do is, for example, you have some result in an A and you have another result in an B. If you want to make those things to be concatenated and stored in an another variable C, what you can do, you can use a write and C. You can write C is equal to, you can open and braces, you can specify A comma B and you can close the braces. Okay, the resultant C will be stored with an A after an C. A will be in an MSB position, C will be in an, B will be in an LSB position. Okay, if you want to replicate the same number n number of times, what you can do, inside the brackets you can specify A how many times it want to replicate it, you can write it. The examples have been shared in the document, you can go through that one. Okay, now let us see an example how you can design in 2:1 mux. Okay, if you take in 2:1 mux, you have in two inputs A and B. There is a select line. Based on the select line condition, the output variable is going to switch. If it is 0, it will be taking an A. If it is 1, it will be taking an B as an option. Okay, if you see an internal diagram of your 2:1 mux, here you have an two AND gates, one OR gate, and then one NOT gate. Total how many gates it has been required? Total 4 gates is required to write an 2:1 mux program in a gate level modeling. But if you write in a data flow modeling, you can complete within a single line also. Okay, now let us see and this examples with an gate level syntax itself. Okay, if you see for an outside word, we have an X, A, and an B and Y as an input output parameters. But where I can store the result of this NOT gate? Okay, in order to store this intermediate signals, we require an wires. We need to declare that one with an wires signals. We can call this as an signals. Here there is an one intermediate result. Here there is an one intermediate result. Here there is an one intermediate results. Okay, we can call that as an W1, W2, and an W3. Okay, now let us go to writing for this code. I think everyone knows that we have already shown that module. It need to have an relevant frame. We have given as mux 2:1. A, B, X, and an Y we have given. A, B is the input. X is an select line. Y is the output. That's what we have declared. Input A, comma B. Input X. Input Y. It can be written in a single line also. If it is having a same number of vectors position, it has been single bit. But here we have written in a two lines. You can extend the lines. No problem. You can write it in a single line. Each input or an output. Okay, before my design body, I need to declare the intermediate signals W1, W2, and W3. Okay, here you can see the W1 is an output of an select line signal here, NOT gate. NOT gate signal, we have discussed an operator, this negation, X, the resultant will be there. Then we are writing an AND gate. The resultant of this one is A and then W1, that's what we have written. Then for W3, it is straight away B and an X. The resultant is W3 we have written. Then for a final Y, it is W2 and an W3 OR operation. Okay, here it has been wrong. You need to make this as a strikeout N. Sorry for the mistakes. There you just check for that one. It has been OR gate is a straight line. Okay, now let us see, rather than using this intermediate wires also, we can write it in a single line by using a conditional operator. What should be my output there? Based on the select line, it need to take an A or B, right? Here I will check that select line X. There in the example, we have taken as an X. Here I have written as an select. I am just checking and select. Then we are going to check. If it is 1 means, it need to take an B. Okay, you can see. If it is select line is 1, it need to take an B input. If it is select line is 0, means it is false, it will take an A. It can be written in a single line. We can avoid the intermediate wires. I hope you can write for all the things, whatever it has been, we have been discussed. Okay, the corrected program, it has been there in a gate level modeling. Here it has a straight line you need to write. I think for you, we are going to give some of the circuits as an think by share analysis, how you can combine the things of and two programs, or and how you can build and given circuits, how effectively. Just think of writing without using an intermediate signal or best operator to implement in any function. We are giving that as an assignment. You need to write it and submit it back. Thank you.